Well, I am going to speak about our work, integration and knowledge organization in a CRIS based on semantic technology. Basically, I am going to praise our CRIS system, but it's a CRIS different because it's based on semantic technologies. First of all, we are going to, in order to pass the next one, please. I can't pass the next one. Sorry. First of all, we are going to see an introduction in order to know how was born the idea, the CRIS university context, problems that promote the goals and objectives we have to reach, our CRIS proposal, our software at the end, and some conclusions. First of all, what is the main responsibility of the university? Because CRIS system is developing in university, as we are going to see. The main responsibilities are research and teaching, but not only. It is necessary also universities share their knowledge with their society in order to look for transparency. So looking for this appear CRIS systems, current research information system. They are software tools that allow us store, manage, show, and share with society the research production of the university in order the research producers can share with the society. But what is CRIS OpenUPSA? What is a different CRIS? It's a CRIS, but different because it allows advanced service, advanced facilities. Mainly, they allow integrate data from different sources, as we are going to see, and advanced sequence system based on semantic technology. And why was born this idea? Why OpenUPSA? Because our university, like the rest, is looking for transparency, but we have had a problem. There isn't an institutional repository in our university. So it's very difficult to share our information with the rest of the world if we don't have this information in a single place. In order to look for this, we decide to design our system. If we study and analyze the situation of the CRIS system at university, we can see we have to answer some questions related to who should maintain this information, if the CRIS should be the institutional repository, or if they have to interact with other institutional repository, in order, for example, for who maintain, libraries have very important in this area, where data come from to a CRIS system, like in our system that came from different parts. Well, in our CRIS system, we also have to answer to all these questions. So what are the problems and objective we plan in order to reach and solve this project? No? About the, as we have said, most universities have the same problems as the AWAS. There isn't any institutional repository. There isn't any single data system. On the other hand, all the university want to look for transparency. But the problem, like in the AWAS, is that the information, the research information, are in different disseminated in different and heterogeneous sources, for example, and different formats. Information can be from PDF, for example, the research curricula are in PDF, but also from web, where information, for example, contain information about the research group in the university, from the library repository, data can be in JSON, for instance, and so on. So we have to solve all of these problems. And for this, we plan our system. And what are the objectives we want to reach? we want research information not only be visualized, that is the main purpose of any CRIS system, but also that the research information could be retrievable and integration from the different sources they are stored, that they can share and reuse if external users want to do it, and that information can be managed, the information that have been integrated. Looking for this objective, we plan our proposal, ¿vale? What are the main specification of our proposal? We want to the visualization of our research information, as we just said, because visualization is the main purpose of any CRIS system, but also, additionally, we want our system also allow us to integrate information from the heterogeneous users where they are stored and manage this data one time they are integrated. And finally, external users can make queries to our system and download the result and reuse it, for instance, in order to create an additional service with add value. And looking for this, we plan looking for alternative. At the end, we have three paths in our system. One to integrate and retrieve information and manage, the other to visualize, like through web information system. And finally, the part of querying and reusing is solved by semantic technologies, as we are going to tell you. For the first part, we want all the information can be in the same place. So all the information is going to be stored in a relational database managed system like is created to be used as single institutional repository. In this in relational database system, we store information about projects, publications, researchers, and so on, research group, and so on. But the problem is this information comes from a heterogeneous source. For these reasons, we have to develop parsers, software tools that translate information from the original formats to our relational database management system. In this context, we have to develop in a translation from a PDF, where are the research curricula, from HTML, where are information about the group published on the web, from external database like Scopus, importing from Excel documents, or from, for example, the information about academic works or researchers are stored in our library repository and are written in JSON format from the API of our library. So we have developed parsers for all these kind of formats. And finally, the other part is allowed to query our system using advanced queries, and not only this, but only that can load the result. For this, we have developed an ontology, not suddenly developed, because our ontology is based on Cerif. Cerif is the common European research information format. It is say the standard format that have been used in Europe to share research information. So, in order to look for a standard, our ontology is based on this one, and we only add some attributes to some classes of the ontology in order to adapt to our specific requirements. Not only this, develop the ontology, but also we develop a semantic repository where the information is stored using this format, and this repository can be queried by a squad part query point. We provide this service, we have developed this service in order we can ask our system using the SparkQL language and return the results that can be downloaded in RDF or in JSON, in order they can reuse it for external users. These are the specific important advances of our system and different to other CRIS systems. And as the result, we develop our software tool, OpenUPSA CRIS system, with which software architecture are divided in three parts: the module that integrate and manage this information, the module who show the information to everybody through the web, and the module that can be queried from this the other two modules in order to query the information. And of course, both store are maintained in parallel. And here we can see the interface of the three parts. The integration and manage, of course, this module is also the users who use it are only internal personnel of university. So we need privilege permissions, special permission to import information from the heterogeneous source and integrate it in the relational database system. But one time integrate, it is also managed from this the same module. The second one are the web, where we can show the information about researcher, project, publication, academic works, thesis, and some statistics that can be used to, for example, help a university to have decisions or to show, for example, how many projects for by year, etc., and share this information with the society. And for example, if we enter in a group research or in a researcher, in particular, we can see specific researchers, we can see their projects, publications, and so on. And finally, the last part is the SQL point system that can be queried from our internal administrative part, the integration and management module part, on from the specific, as we can just see, from here, we can also access our SQL point from the web, where we can make our SQL queries and return the results and download them. So finally, as conclusion, our OpenUPSA CRIS system is different from the usual CRIS system because they provide also facilities to integrate and manage information from different sources that come from different sources, because they also allow us to download the information we want to query, and in this way we can reuse this data, and this is allowed thanks to the use of semantic technology. And finally, as a consequence of this developed system, we also can contribute with the parsers we have developed that can be used in other contexts. We only provide an ontology derived from CRIS and our software tool. That is the main contribution, of course, looking for our university, UPISE, Pontifica University of Salamanca, Transparente. And that's all. Here are our contacts. And our university, if you want to ask more things about our proposal. Of course, you can make questions now if you want.
Thank you very much, right in time. Yeah. We have some questions were asked in the chat. One is, how does OpenUPSA compare to the Vivo CRIS system? So Vivo is very common.
How can UPSA what?
Compared to the system Vivo. Vivo is a similar system that's used in several, at least I know in German universities, but also internationally. Compared and evaluated other systems before building your own?
We review other, but at the end we decide to use CRIS as the base ontology, because of the it is supposed to be it is defined as the common European information system. In this common European for research information format. In this way, we decide for this. Not is better or worse than Vivo as format, but we prefer a common European format. Is the not is better or worse? It's only because they are it is supposed more standard.
Okay, and in addition to this, so you built more on your own, and have you published parts of the software you developed as open source?
By the moment, this is only as a prototype in our in our university, because we have to introduce more research. By the moment, we only added some researches. We have a lot of researches in our university, and by the moment there isn't everybody inside this contest. For this reason, by the moment it is not public. It is only for internal use, like a prototype, accessible from our library as an innovation project. But not to everybody, because we only have a little part of our information integrated by the moment.
Okay, so you still need to convince people in the university to make this like going live, don't you?
I'm afraid, but I think we are in the good path.
Okay. Another question: could you, how technically the relational database is connected to the semantic data store?
How
is the relational database connected to the semantic?
Yeah, both are in parallel. So when we introduce some information or we manage information related to the database system, in parallel we update the semantic repository. Okay, we introduce the new class, instance, and so on, and update it in the semantic query at the same time. We decide to develop two repository and work in parallel with them, because one have more advantage in one for the relational database systems. Within it is in this context it is easier, for example, to manage information or integrate for another things, but mainly to manage. But if we wanted specific queries and download the information and so on, and for example to share with other European CRIS system that use also, for example, Theri Forma, we thought a semantic repository will be better. For this reason, at the end, we decide to work with both at the same time.